everyone, today in Sangi's Cookery, we're going to see a chundal variety. It is nothing but the red kidney bean or the rajma chundal. Chundal is a healthy snack which has been pressure cooked and by adding a few masala powders as well as the grated coconut. So this is usually served in South India during the Navratri. All 9 days we do different varieties of chundal. And this is going to be a khatta meetha chundal, which means it has got more of sour taste as well as a sweet taste. So it's going to be really different. So let's see how we can prepare it.
I've taken 1 cup of rajma. I've soaked it overnight. 2 to 3 tablespoons of grated coconut. Some curry leaves. I've soaked 1 small lemon size of tamarind. Along with that, I've soaked some 3-4 dates. 1 tablespoon of jaggery powder. Some salt as per taste. Some turmeric powder. 1 teaspoon of red chilli powder. 1 teaspoon of grated ginger. For frying, 2 teaspoons of dhania. 2 teaspoons of sauce. 2 teaspoons of jeera and 1 teaspoon of black pepper. For seasoning, 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1 teaspoon of urad dal, 1 red chilli and 2 teaspoons of coconut oil. First, let's dry fry dhania, sauf, jeera and the pepper. I've been frying for about a minute and I'm able to get a good fragrance and it's likely to start to splutter, especially the jeera and the peppercorns. You can off the gas. Make this into a fine powder and this can be another powder which you can use for all kinds of chundals. Now you can see I've made a fine powder. I'm just going to transfer this to a plate and in the same mixie I'm just going to grind the soaked tamarind and also I'll add 2 to 3 dates. All these things I've soaked it in hot water. Along with this I'll be adding a tablespoon of powdered jaggery and I'll make it into a fine paste. If you have the dates imli chutney which you use for making the bhel puri, you can add this instead of this. I'm adding about 2 to 3 teaspoons of coconut oil. Once the oil gets heated up, I'll add the mustard seeds and the urad dal. Once the mustard seeds begin to splutter, we'll add the red chilli and 1/2 teaspoon of hing and some curry leaves. I'm also adding the 2 tablespoons of grated coconut. Just fry for a few minutes. Now I'll be adding the cooked rajma. I've actually pressure cooked this for about 9 whistles and I've soaked it overnight. So it is cooked well. Just going to add this. Though I've actually cooked the rajma with salt and turmeric powder, I'm adding some more salt. So you can taste and add the salt accordingly. After adding the rajma, if there is some water, let the water get fully absorbed. Just keep in medium flame. And I'll just cover it and cook it for 5 more minutes. So it's been about 5 minutes. I'm also adding 1 tablespoon of the paste. Also adding 1 teaspoon of red chilli powder. Now I'm also adding the powdered mixture. Mix it up nicely. I'm also adding 1 teaspoon of grated ginger. Give it a good stir. And can switch off the gas. Finally, I'm just going to garnish with some fresh grated coconut and mix it up. So it will have the flavor of sourness, sweetness, spice and everything.
The very tasty rajma or the red kidney bean chundal is ready to be served. It's said that by eating a bowl or a small cup of the red kidney beans, you're getting 15 grams of protein. So it is rich, really high in protein. So this is definitely important for the growing children and also for the people who are working out because they need to have protein, especially for the vegetarian. You don't get protein from different sources. So this is one of the high protein dish. And also in this particular chundal, I have used a special powder by dry roasting, and if you see in my chana chundal, I've used a different powder, so you can try various combinations. And during your Navratri, you can make different types of chundal by adding in different flavors. So I hope you'll all enjoy eating this chundal. And if you like, please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Have a great day.